I'll be home for Christmas. Where else would I be? Hey, good evening, and welcome, and Merry Christmas, everyone. Welcome to episode 84 of the House Arrest Concert Series. Nice and cold. With me, your host and sole performer, Bill Spence. Coming to you live on this Christmas evening. A very variant Christmas, as it were. And I'm going to try to do some things that are appropriate for the day, and I hope you enjoy. We'll see how it goes. Merry Christmas, everybody. Sleigh Ride. Get out of here. Not gonna happen. One of my favorite songs. I always mess it up when I play it, so. Merry freaking Christmas. I didn't want to do all Christmas carols tonight. Let me check my recording device first, though. Wow, holy smokes. Ruining Christmas for people all over the country. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Today is actually, it's Christmas Day, 2021. It is actually National Pumpkin Pie Day. Who knew? And it's also Alphabet Day. Get it? Noel. Alphabet. Birthday is today. Debatably our Lord and Savior Jesus, but you know, Was he a Capricorn? Was he a Pisces? Was he more like a Leo? The debate goes on 2,000 years plus. But we know whose birthday it is today. It was Annie Lennox's birthday. She was born the same year as I. She is 67. So she is basically the same age as I. Jimmy Buffett, he's an old fart. He turned 75 today. Isaac Newton turns several hundred years dead today. Humphrey Bogart, several decades dead today, as with Rod Serling. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, 50 years old today. And clocking in at 73 is Mary Clayton, one of the stars of 20 Feet from Stardom. A background singer, you'll know her for singing the duet with Mick Jagger on Gimme Shelter. You know, War Children is just a shot away. Speaking of war, in 1914, today marked the Christmas Truce. Troops on the front lines in Germany in 1914, Christmas morning, they approached the enemy lines unarmed, singing carols and saying Merry Christmas in the enemy's language. They shook hands, traded gifts, cigarettes, plum pudding, and there was even a documented instance of a little soccer game going on between the troops. And this was only about 5 months after the outbreak of hostilities in World War I, and it kind of ended the era of chivalry and warfare. There were no more Christmas truces after that. A Christmas movie is something I always like to do. We're at 1962. I may have gone to see To Kill a Mockingbird. That opened. What else we got? 1996. JonBenet Ramsey. In 1776, Washington crossed the Delaware with 2,400 troops in his contingent. There were 3,000 others that didn't quite make it to the meeting place in time. Nevertheless, they surrounded a bunch of groggy Hessians, like 1,400 of them, on the 26th. And it was a famous battle. Wasn't terribly much for strategic measures, but it was good PR. 1991, Mikhail Gorbachev resigned on this day, 4 days after 11 Soviet republics joined the Commonwealth of Independent States, pretty much gutting the Soviet Union. So, peace, the order of the day today. Well, it's not all Christmas songs. But I kind of went on a stream of consciousness tear. And thought of Christmas songs. What's associated with Christmas? How about holly? How about the hollies? Burst out with the issues there, I say, can share my umbrella. Bust up, bust cause she stays the girls under my umbrella. All that summer we'd enjoyed, wind and rain and shine. That umbrella we'd employed, by August she was mine. Every morning I would see her waiting at the stop. Sometimes she she would show me what she bought. Other people stared as if we were born acquainted and saying, someday my name and hers are gonna be 10cc. But the Bus Stop was a number 5 hit in 1966 for the Hollies. This was this band's biggest hit, number 1 for several weeks in 1984. It contained a very mysterious video, presumably that took place. The shot as if it took place in Mississippi in 1870. I just saw it the other day. Well, trying to remember what this sound, this song sounds like. Thank you. 1975 in their album Told You a Stream of Consciousness. So after Culture Club, I got into this for some reason. In the beginning, There was something of love that was mine. Now that it's gone, oh, I'm crying. Oh, the time that it takes for love to grow cold is a wonder to me. Walking around with my head hanging down, tell me where is she? Give me silver, blue, and gold. Christmas horse. Merry Christmas. Next one written by the team Bobby Scott and Bob Russell. They were introduced, they were introduced to each other by Johnny Mercer. When they were writing this song, they only met three times, and this is the only song that came out of it. Bob Russell was suffering from lymphoma, and he passed away shortly after they finished this song. It was recorded by a guy named Kelly Gordon in 1969. He was not famous for anything other than marrying Bobby Gentry. But anyway, Johnny Mercer introduced Bobby Scott and Bob Russell. They wrote this song. And it was a number seven hit for the Hollies in 1969. It was re-released in 1988 and became a number one hit. In the 1969 number seven version, Elton John played the piano.
Brother.
go. His welfare is my concern. No burden is he to bear. We'll get there. For I know he would not encumber me. He ain't heavy. He's my brother. If I'm laden at all, I'm laden with sadness that everyone's heart isn't filled with the gladness of love. It's a long, long road from which there is no return. While we're on our way there, why not share? He's my brother. He's my brother. He's my brother. He ain't heavy. He's my brother.
Reminded of Boys Town, 1938. Anyway, yeah, 1969, number 7 hit. 1970, a big hit for Neil Diamond, actually. And 1988, once again, for the Hollies. And Holly, sparking ideas in my head. Holly, ivy, all that sort of stuff. And a Christmas garland comes to mind. And, this song, written by Hugh Martin and Ralph Blaine for the 1944 MGM musical Meet Me in St. Louis, actually hit number 27 on the Billboard charts in 1944. A big favorite with the boys overseas. And it was sung by Judy Garland a few years later in the late 50s, I think. Frank Sinatra did a different version with slightly different lyrics. This is the one with the less depressing lyrics. It's one of my favorite Christmas songs. Resident of the French town of Rocamart. That's Roca like Roquefort and Mar like Mari, but with an E. Rocamart. On the Rhone, a little bit north of Avignon, and actually the place where the Côte de Rhone wine appellation came into being, the center of Côte de Rhone. Also, unfortunately, the place where the phylloxera plague hit France in the 1860s. Look it up. But anyway, a poem by a Rocamore resident, Placide Capot, was put to music by Adolphe Charles Adam. And this is my mom's favorite Christmas carol. My mom was raised Episcopalian. She has a strong British background, so the Anglican, the version of Anglican in America is Episcopalian. Didn't sit well with the powers that be in my father's Catholic church. So my mom was able to supply a good balance of skepticism at the church because of their mixed marriage. Unbelievable in this day and age. But anyway, this was always the one that we closed the show with. Stain upon history, I mean mark. So again, Merry Christmas to those near and far. Though you may be out of my sight, you're never out of my mind. Out of mind, don't apply to you outside out of mind.
another place and time. Well, we might have seen it through, 'cause I love the way we rhyme, and I know you will hear it too. Well, you had to heed your calling, well, that's the way it had to be. Now my tears are falling, and I'm wishing, wishing you were here with me. Out of sight, out of mind, but it just isn't true. Well, that's a silly old line, don't apply to you. Out of sight, out of mind, don't know what to do. Yes, my magnum opus, Out of Sight, Out of Mind. 45 minutes of your Christmas evening wasted with me. Thank you once again. I'll see you back here in 2022 for episode 85. Yikes. So, once again, Merry Christmas, everybody. Until next time, ciao, ciao.